The senator from South Carolina.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, we have had an opportunity for the last several hours to go back and forth to debate the benefits or the negatives of this bill. This is a historic night for America. 31 years in the making, and if you're watching this debate at home, you might be a little confused. As Democrats and Republicans continue to talk about the same bill using very different perspectives, and folks must be wondering, where is the truth? And Mr. President, I would like to spend a few minutes clarifying some of the important points, some of the misinformation that's coming from the left. First, Mr. President, this is not a health care bill. Our friends on the left have suggested that somehow, some way, that this bill will eliminate coverage for millions and millions of Americans. They will lose their coverage. Mr. President, the only thing this bill actually does is eliminates the penalty for those folks who decide not to buy health insurance. In other words, Mr. President, this bill reduces the tax burden on families who are working paycheck to paycheck. One third of the families, Mr. President, who pay the penalty are families who make less than $25,000. Mr. President, 80% of the folks who pay the penalty make less than $50,000. And Mr. President, contrary to popular belief on the left, no one loses their insurance, but yes, they will have the option to do what is in their family's best interest, what is in the individual's best interest. Mr. President, we have sought for ways to work with our friends on the other side because we know that this legislation is not about the Republican Party. It's not about conservatives, nor is it about liberals. It's about Americans, Americans who for too long have worked too hard and seen too little in their paychecks. Mr. President, the government does not create jobs. No matter what either side says, we don't create jobs. But we can, through this tax reform package, increase take-home pay by taking less out. Now, Mr. President, somebody asked the question, what does that mean, taking less out? Well, Mr. President, for your average single parent in America, who makes the average income of $41,000, as my good friend from Alaska already stated, that individual household will see about a 73% cut in their taxes. Said differently, Mr. President, that means an increase in their take-home pay. Now, Mr. President, I was thinking about folks back at home in South Carolina, one person in particular, Sherry, who is a single mother, two kids, trying to start a new business. Here's an opportunity to have just a little more margin at the end of each pay period. $1,300. These are real dollars, and my friends on the left seem to suggest that a 73% cut in the typical single-parent household's tax burden is not an increase. Well, Mr. President, the story continues. For the average family in America making $73,000, they're looking at a tax cut of 58%, over $2,000 more in their paycheck. When I talk to my friends who are typical Americans, Michelle and Joe, living in South Carolina, working hard, raising two beautiful kids, having a 60% cut in their taxes is real middle class relief. This is a bill that delivers. And the good news is, only in about 7 or 8 weeks, the average American will have an answer to which side is right. Is it the left or is it the right? The fact is that they will be able to take a look in their own paychecks and determine for themselves the benefits of this tax cut. Mr. President, when we think about the things that we should be working on to restore confidence that the average person has lost in the government, to restore that, we do that by making sure that our tax proposal speaks to the average family. So, Mr. President, we do double the standard deduction for individuals from $6,300 to $12,000, for single-parent households from $9,300 to $18,000, and for two-earner households. Mr. President, we essentially create a 0% tax bracket for folks living at the federal poverty level of $24,000 by doubling the standard deduction to $24,000, we have essentially created a 0% tax bracket. But the good news is it gets better for those folks with children in the house, where your child tax credit used to be $1,000, now the child tax credit is $2,000, with 70% of that amount being refundable, an increase from what it used to be. Mr. President, so many folks on the other side have talked about whether or not this is simplification. But when 95 out of 100 tax filers can simply use the standard deduction, it means that, yes, on the back of a clean piece of paper, someone can determine their tax burden. This is good news. 6 billion hours spent annually doing their taxes, we are going to cut that number down significantly. And for our friends living in blue states, where the SALT, state and local tax debate, has been so important, we have decided to sweeten the SALT solution by allowing a hybrid of either your property taxes or income taxes to be used within that $10,000 threshold. Mr. President, we've even made it easier through 529 plans to prepare and to pay for education, K through 12, as well as college. The one thing I will say, Mr. President, that we've heard a lot of from our friends on the other side, and you'll hear more of it tonight, it's FEAR. It's an acronym that means false evidence appearing real. It's not the truth, but fear sells, and it seems as though my friends on the other side have decided that if you just keep saying it, it must be true. And over and over and over, and we'll hear it more when I'm finished, folks demonizing this legislation. The facts are simple, and Senator Cardin said it himself, and I wrote it down when he said it, because I was like, wow, that is a clear, concise, true statement. Senator Cardin said, major tax relief for families, our bill. Mr. President, we are on the verge of resetting American competitiveness. By lowering our corporate tax rate, we will allow the jobs of the future to be created here at home. With a 20% cut in your qualified business income, we will see small businesses prospering. And when they prosper, they'll hire more folks. And as I was in the gym on this past weekend, small business owner who runs a battery company, 7 employees, said on January 1st, he's hiring a new person. Mr. President, a survey done of manufacturers, 7,000 manufacturers, the vast majority said that with this tax cut, they will hire more people, they will increase wages, and they will improve benefits. This is good news from a global perspective. This is good news from a small business perspective. And this is good news from an individual perspective. Mr. President, it is time for us to complete the people's business and vote. Vote yes for tax cuts. Vote yes for improved business climate. And vote yes, yes, for a global competition where American companies and American workers are winning. Mr. President, I yield the floor.